Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In the previous video, you learnt all about copying timeline effects within the effects environment. This covered a variety of use cases, including copying a set of timeline effects to multiple shots. Now this is all very well and good when working within the sequence, but there are quite a few instances where you might want to save the grading or VFX settings as presets. Perhaps you have a specific effect or grade that you're using in a campaign. Or maybe you want to save a variety of grades to try them out or keep them for later. So let's focus on creating presets in the effects environment. This video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. Now you are currently seeing a track with multiple segments in the effects environment. Some segments have a mix of VFX and grading, and there are some that have nothing currently applied. So the common situation is that you are working on a specific shot, and you'd like to save that timeline effects as a preset. In this case, the shot has been graded, and I'll toggle between the F1 and F4 keyboard shortcuts to show you the original and the result. In order to create a preset, you are going to need to store it somewhere. If you don't already have it on screen, reveal the media panel. This can either be done through the drop-down menu or the Shift-Escape keyboard shortcut. For those of you who prefer a more gestural action, hold Control and swipe to the edge of the screen. Now, the most obvious thought when it comes to the media panel is that it is designed to manage your media and sequences, but it can also be used as a place to store VFX and grading presets. To create a preset, grab your timeline effects, either from the storyboard thumbnail or effects pipeline, and drop it into the media panel. There is your effects clip, which is your preset, and it uses the name from the segment you pulled it from. You can rename it, but that's up to you. As a tip, you could also use the copy and paste contextual menu or keyboard shortcuts to create the preset if you prefer working that way. Now, to apply this preset to another segment in the storyboard, you simply drag and drop the clip to another thumbnail. That's it. If you want to apply the preset to multiple thumbnails in the storyboard, you multi-select the thumbnails first and then drag and drop the effects clip. So it's rarely easy to start using presets straight away, and you can create as many as you want. Towards the end of this video, you'll learn how to store multiple timeline effects in a single preset. But right now, I want to stress that you have access to the entire organizational levels within the workspace via the media panel. So typically, you'd also have media and sequence clips in the media panel. To avoid media getting in the way of any presets you create, the media panel uses a series of tab filtering at the top of the panel. When you work within the effects environment, the media panel locks itself to the effects tab filtering. This means that only your presets will be displayed whenever you're in this environment. The other tabs are grayed out, but as soon as you return to the timeline, Flame reactivates the other tabs, as well as switches back to your original chosen tab, so you don't have to keep clicking back and forth. You can still switch to the effects tab in the timeline view if you want, but it's not necessary moving between the timeline and the effects environment. As soon as you go back into the effects environment, the effects tab is applied to the media panel automatically. It's also worth mentioning that the collapse and expand status of objects are persistent. For example, a reel or folder that was expanded in the effects tab, but you collapsed it in the all tab. When you switch between the tabs, the reel or folder will remember whether it was expanded or collapsed, so you don't need to keep looking or changing things. Now you can save your grade and effects presets anywhere in the media panel, so you could mix effects clips with media and sequences. However, I have two suggestions for organization. The first suggestion is to use a separate reel or folder to store your presets. For example, we'll create a new folder in the library, and I'll call it My Effects. You can move and copy presets like regular clips, but like before, you can just drag them from the effects environment. The second suggestion in organizing your presets is if you are working collaboratively with other flame artists, you could store your presets in the shared library, and everyone can access your presets and vice versa. Presets can be wired and archived since they are considered as part of the workspace. Let's create a few more presets. We'll just go to another thumbnail in the storyboard and drag its timeline effects to the My Effects folder. So both these effects clips contain a single timeline effects. Let's move to a segment containing multiple timeline effects. Now, if you want to save a preset that contains multiple grading or VFX tools, you hold Ctrl and click the timeline effects to select them. Drag the selection into the media panel and an effects clip will be created. If you press Alt and click on the clip, it will show you the effects tools stored in the preset. So this is how you create presets and apply them to segments in the sequence. The last thing I'd like to mention is that Batch Effects or BFX is considered a separate entity to the effects environment. Therefore, you cannot make a BFX preset and apply it within the effects environment. In order to do that, you need to be working in the timeline view, and you'll be able to copy and paste the BFX toolset. In the next video, we'll discuss interactive rendering and performance improvements when working in the effects environment. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.